inequations questions that can be solved using factorization. Let's take a complex example such as this one. You have four different terms. The right way is to equate each term to 0 and you will get four nodes. For example, x minus 2 is equal to 0 will give a node x is equal to 2. So you will have four nodes. Please draw these four nodes on the number line. You have these four nodes. Now see, of these four values, which value is the smallest? X minus 3 is the smallest value represented by this respective node. So what happens to the polynomial when the value of x is less than 3 in this entire region? Imagine in this region, x minus 3 is going to be something positive because x is greater than 3. It is on the right side of 3. So x minus 3 is positive. And if x minus 3 is positive, the other 3 are of course positive because they are greater than x minus 3. So the value of polynomial will have 4 positive terms being multiplied, and therefore effectively in this range where x is greater than 3, we will have a positive value of the polynomial. What happens at 3? At each of these nodes, please understand, the value would be 0 because one of these terms would become 0. And between 2 and 3, what will happen? See, between 2 and 3, x minus 3 will become negative. However, all the other terms will remain positive. So effectively, we will have one negative term and then three positive terms, leading to a negative value of the polynomial. And therefore, between 2 and 3, the value of the given expression becomes negative. Now, between 2 and negative 5, in this range, what would happen is even x minus 2 will become negative. So we will have two negative terms and two positive terms. Effectively, we will have a positive value of the polynomial. And accordingly, you will keep getting alternate negative and positive signs. So the rightmost value is always going to be positive, and then you will have alternate negative and positive signs. And therefore, the answer is we need the positive values, and therefore the answer is x greater than 3, this particular range, or this particular range when x is between negative 5 and positive 2, or the third range when x is less than minus 6. Let's take one more example. A simpler one, this one. Please pause the video, try doing it yourself. Step 1, draw the number line. Step 2, equate each term in the expression to 0. You find 3 nodes. The nodes are 0, positive 1 and positive 6. Draw them. On the right side of 6, you will have positive value of the expression, then alternate negative and positive values. The question wants negative values of the expression, and therefore we choose these two particular ranges where the value of the expression is negative. And therefore, the required answer is that x is between 1 and 6 or x is less than 0. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.